Roll into town, step off the bus, shake off the where you came from dust. Grab your guitar, walk down the street, sign says Nashville, Tennessee. But I have found...
What does it mean to be a veterinarian? It means long hours, long days, but in the end, it's a wonderful career, it's a wonderful profession and lifestyle. You get to meet interesting people and work with amazing animals.
So to be a vet, I would say it means to help people and help animals, usually at the same time, to help animals live a better quality of life, and to help people enjoy their animals as well.
I think my favorite part of the job probably is in the spring when I get to work with the babies, because I love little fuzzy wuzzy creatures with four legs. I don't have children of my own, so the baby foals are my children. So that's my favorite part of the job.
The best part of being a veterinarian, in particular an equine veterinarian, I think is just being able to work with all the animals. But obviously when you can figure things out and help a client and help a patient, that's the best thing.
I think worst part of the job, which makes logical sense, death, dead animals, euthanizing them. You know, these guys got here probably because some other poor vet had to euthanize these guys. So it's never a fun part of the job. We do what we have to do. Very emotional, but worst part.
Worst part of the job would be, I would say euthanasia as well, but also seeing some of the horses that don't live in the best conditions that you would really like to help, but you really can't. That would probably be my downside to this job.
I always thought that I would work with animals in some way, shape or another, either definitely hopefully with horses. But I didn't know right off the bat that I wanted to be a veterinarian until I lived in England for a short period of time and worked at a hospital over there and got the bug.
I absolutely always knew I wanted to work with animals. I decided a long time ago that I really wanted to be a veterinarian, but throughout the years that kind of changed, but I still wanted to be a technician so I could work with any type of animals, and horses was my top choice.
Probably my most memorable case was, I think it was the first or second year I've been working, and I actually got called to a barn right around the corner from the clinic, and they had a horse that had run into a vertical I-beam in the indoor ring. It actually split its head in half. And at that time, although I was pretty new, I'd seen a lot of stuff and I was pretty good with everything, but I had no idea where to start. So I called Dr. Berthold, who's one of the senior veterinarians in, and he came over. And he got there, and he was about the same as me, and he was like, I don't know where to start with this. So he ended up calling Dr. Genovese, who's been in practice for 50 years, and ended up it was myself, Dr. Berthold, Dr. Genovese, and Dr. Corey Paradine eventually came over, and it took all of us working together to fix the horse. We ended up having to take out one of its eyes because it was totally gone and useless. It was already blind in the other eye because when it split its head open, not only did it make a hole into its head, it actually yanked its eyeballs kind of where they cross over underneath the brain. So that was just kind of a crazy case. The horse ended up living, even though we had recommended euthanasia to the owner. It lived several years blind with both eyes, the one obviously gone, the other one not being able to be used. And you could actually see inside the horse's head into its sinus cavity. And it lived like that, I would say, fairly happy for a couple of years before it passed away. So that was pretty memorable.
My most memorable case would be a horse out, I don't even know exactly where it was. A horse had been, I think, stepped on itself or kicked or got caught in a fence, something to that extent. The owner didn't call anybody out till many days later, and a vet had already seen it. They had bandaged it. We came out a few days later because the horse was down and couldn't get up, and we took the bandage off the horse's leg, and it was infested infested with maggots, like head to toe, and you could literally see the bone, like, just sticking out at you. It was absolutely disgusting, and the smell was horrible. That would be my most, one of my most memorable, yucky memorable, but most memorable.
She wants her nails painted black. She wants the toy in the Cracker Jack. She wants to ride the bull at the rodeo. She wants to wear my shirt to bed. She wants to make every stray a pet and drive around in my truck with no place to go. But she needs to feel that fire. The one that lets her know for sure she's everything I want and more. Her real desire is to know I'd walk alone out on the wild to make her feel that fire. She wants a cabin in the woods. She wants to stand where nobody stood. Someday she wants a couple kids of her own. She wants to make love on a train. Some days she only wants a break. Hey, she wants what she wants. The man I know, I know, I know. She needs to feel that fire. The one that lets her know for sure she's everything